Before we dive into the changes that have been made to the Drupal 8 interface, let's start by painting a broader picture of the kinds of improvements that have been made for both users and administrators. First of all, Drupal is responsive out of the box, which means that it can fit to a variety of screen sizes, from mobile phones to desktop browsers, and the responsiveness extends to the administrative section so you can manage your site from your phone. There are also new APIs that contributed modules and themes can plug into to make responsiveness even easier. In Drupal 8, the Views module, which is responsible for creating lists of content, is now in core, which means that virtually any list of content that you see on Drupal, both on the front end and the administrative section, is now a view that can be modified and adjusted just like you can modify any view. This also means that you can do a lot more with Drupal out of the box. Next, the block system has been completely overhauled. Now we can have multiple instances of the same block in multiple regions of a page. Nearly every element of the site that used to be part of the theme has now been embedded in a block, which can be enabled, disabled, or adjusted, making it less necessary to use contributed modules to get the same effect. You can also have different types of blocks, and each type of block can have its own set of fields, so blocks have become as extendable as content types. Drupal 8 comes bundled with a WYSIWYG now, so when we edit content, we don't have to write an HTML or markup. This is so important for some of our less geeky users, and it can really speed up the editing process. The WYSIWYG is fully configurable, and you can have different WYSIWYGs for different users and different text formats. In addition to the WYSIWYG, Drupal 8 supports in-place editing. So if we're on a page with some content, we can edit any aspect of that content in line. Drupal 8 has been upgraded to HTML5, and this has many implications, only a few of which are user-facing. One of those is that we can now use HTML5 input types, like date fields, email addresses, and more. It also means a huge win for accessibility and for clean HTML code. When it comes to working with the file system, Drupal 8 has had its entire file structure reorganized to be more intuitive to the initial user. Custom themes go in the themes folder, custom modules go in the modules folder, and the code that belongs to core, which isn't something we should be modifying or working with, ends up in the core folder, so it's a lot easier to know what you can modify and what you shouldn't. Drupal 8 has improved multilingual support. Through a pretty straightforward user interface, you can enable multiple languages, translate nearly any aspect of the interface or any aspect of the configuration, like custom views and blocks, and also any content. It's easy to search for content that hasn't been translated yet, and through these tools, you can also make adjustments to the interface text without having to use any contributed modules. The comment system has also been vastly improved. Now, instead of just having one type of comment, you can have multiple types of comments, just like you can with blocks and content types. And now, the comment form and the display of the comments is a field, which means that you can add comments to various kinds of entities, and you can add multiple comment streams to the same kind of entity. Drupal 8 comes with a form builder, which is kind of a cross between the core contact module and the contributed web form module. With it, you can create multiple forms, and they're all fieldable, and it also includes the user-specific contact form that the contact module gave us in Drupal 7. Drupal 8 has had a number of performance improvements, and a few of the front-facing ones that we might notice are that 1. The site is cached for anonymous visitors by default, and there's been improved mechanisms to make sure that the cached version of the site matches up with the most recent content. CSS and JavaScript are now aggregated by default, and jQuery, which is the biggest JavaScript library in Drupal core, is only loaded when it's needed. So if your front-facing site doesn't need jQuery, there will be a slight performance boost for your users. Drupal 8 is also more accessible. If we look at the source code real quick for the homepage, and we do a search for ARIA, you can see that there's numerous ARIA tags scattered throughout the code. These give important information to screen readers, and Drupal supports these labels, as well as other accessibility best practices through its APIs, meaning that without even trying, a lot of contributed modules and custom code will be able to leverage the accessibility improvements as well. You may have noticed as we worked through the administrative interface that there's been numerous improvements to the design patterns that are used throughout the administrative section. It's cleaner, clearer, it's responsive, and it's just a lot more of a pleasure to use. In Drupal 8, view modes are now user-configurable without any contributed modules. What this means is that we can create different displays of our content and reuse those displays in multiple places, most notably in views and other contributed modules that will help with layout. Drupal 8 also includes an interface for adjusting form modes, which is the way that we see the form that we use to create content or other entities. But as of the initial release of Drupal 8, there's not really a way to use them yet, though I'm sure that there will be soon. There's a whole slew of contributed modules that we no longer need in Drupal 8. For example, we no longer need views, internationalization, entity reference, date field, email field, web form, at least for a limited set of use cases, the link module, the string override module, and quite a few more. There are still going to be some core contributed modules that we'll almost definitely need, including rules, path auto, and possibly web form. But there's still a whole lot that we can do out of the box with 8. Okay, if you're like me, then this list of improvements is really energizing, and you're probably excited to dive in. So in these next videos, what we're going to do is dive into the interface and go step by step through all of the interface changes that have been made. The process will take some time, but it will also take a lot less time than it would if you were clicking through the interface on your own. Plus, it's really powerful to see how these changes impact one another and what it's going to mean for our overall experience.